Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm testing out the foundation from Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I've been trying to make a video on this a few times already. I've tried the foundation a few times. It wasn't really successful the previous time, so I said I'm gonna give it one last try. This is how the foundation looks like on my skin. Anyway, without any further ado, let's go barefaced and apply the foundation and track how it works for the rest of the day. I'm just gonna read you off the website of Wet n Wild what they say about this foundation. So mainly, this is what I see in the description, in the benefits. They mainly mention the lack of flashback, white cast in your photos. Now, I will never buy foundation just because it doesn't give me flashback and white cast in photos. I definitely want to know that the foundation performs well on my skin, a part of pictures. I don't walk all day taking pictures. I know some people do, but that's not me. I want my foundation to look well on my skin. It doesn't matter under flashlight or no. I'm treating this foundation like an everyday foundation because it's so affordable as a price. Here it says $6.50. This is American dollars. Now I guess the price vary in every country, so you can check for yourself in your country. I'll be totally honest with you. I tried this foundation about 2-3 times until now. Every time, until now, was unsuccessful. Something was wrong with, I don't know, I was giving it on my skin. Maybe something was wrong with my skin. Maybe something was wrong with the rest of the makeup which I applied. I don't know. Today I will be using only products which I know very well how they work. I will set the foundation with the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. This one, you're well familiar with it. You can't see anything from the lights probably, but that's the transparent Stay Matte Powder from Rimmel. And the shade range, I see they've got 20 shades and I see many light shades. By the way, my nails are totally broken. Ignore this. I'm going to fix them in an hour probably. 20 shades, many light shades, not enough dark shades. I don't know what's with the companies. People of color need and want to wear foundation as well. This is what I see, like a shade range. And if you tell me that these shades are dark enough for women of color, I don't know. So I'm starting off with the usual primer which I use when I test foundations. This is the Catrice Prime and Fine, a pore refining anti-shine base. I'm using this because I just love it. It's affordable. And yeah, it's nice primer. So I've decided to apply the foundation with a sponge on one side of my face and with a brush on the other side, just in case, just to make sure that my opinion is not affected by the way I apply the foundation in any way. So I'll be using the angled Kabuki brush F84 from Sigma, is one of my favorites, and the Beauty Sponge from Amazon, which I really like. I've already tried, so I know it works well. By the way, the shade which I'm using is golden beige and it matches me perfectly. This I know for sure. So I'm just gonna apply a few dots on one side, blend it with a brush, and then apply just a bit more on the other side too. But I will use the sponge. Okay, so one layer is done with the brush and you can obviously see that the coverage is not they don't mention full coverage, but the coverage is definitely light to medium, let's say, for most of my face. Oh, my hair. This here, you see this pigmentation, it didn't cover it whatsoever. I mean, just the tiniest amount. Just have a look at both sides without the foundation, one layer, and with the foundation. I definitely need a bit more, especially there where I have the pigmentation. I hope the second layer will give me a bit more coverage. I mean, I can definitely see my flaws, my spots. Here I had a spot which I just used some foundation on top. Here I don't need so much coverage, but here the like I can still see some redness shining through around my nose, so definitely I'll go for a second layer. And you have to consider that this brush from Sigma, I mean the F80 flat kabuki, the angled kabuki, this one which I'm using, they are quite, like they give you a lot of coverage, definitely. I mean, I know that if I want the most of a coverage from a foundation, I have to use these brushes. Because they're so dense, they definitely, you know, like pack product on your skin. Okay, so this is the foundation, two layers. I don't like the way it sits in my pores. When I mentioned in the beginning that that was unsuccessful the few times when I tried it, it was the same thing. This was the first thing which came across my mind when I, you know, like after applying the foundation, is that it sits weird in my pores. So even from a distance here in the mirror, I can see the foundation like, I mean, it immediately caked here. I don't know if you can see here. I'm moving on to the other side. The coverage with the sponge is definitely less than the coverage with the brush, obviously. And I don't know if you can see, I'm sure you can see that. I mean, I can see my spot quite well. So I'm applying a second layer. It's really lightweight. This I have to say, it feels lightweight on the skin. But when I look at it, it feels like it's like caked in my pores, which is a weird thing, because it feels so light in general, you know. You wouldn't think that it's gonna sit in your pores. Like, all in all, that's it with the foundation. I will finish off my makeup and I'll come back to you, so you know, like I can tell you how everything applied on top, did I have any problems, and yeah, I'll see you in a minute then. So I finish off my makeup and this is how everything looks like. That's a simple everyday makeup with the drugstore, with drugstore products only. This is, I filmed for the Bulgarian channel. So this is how everything looks like. To be honest, it doesn't look so bad, the foundation. I didn't have any problem to fix it, you know, applying all the rest of the products. Anyway, as I told you in the beginning, I will use only products which I've used before. I know how they work. So I don't want anything to affect the way that the foundation looks. It's not bad. I will immediately say that it's not my favorite foundation. Still, I still think that it sits weird in my pores. It definitely here, it immediately, it's still creasing, you know, here on my in my fine lines around my nose and around my mouth. But that's normal, since I mean my fine lines are quite deep. So I don't expect from any foundation to not sit there at all. Once I powder the foundation, I think it looks better, you know, when I apply the rest of my makeup. And I'll see you a bit later, after a few hours, so we can see together how the foundation performs, how oily my skin looks like after a few hours. I will zoom you in the next time when I'm back. So yeah, that's it from me now, and see you in a bit. Hey guys, I'm back and it's been about 12 hours since I'm wearing the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation, and I have a few thoughts. So first of all, I apologize that I couldn't make check-in early at about the 6 or 7 hour mark, but to be honest, I don't see a huge difference since then. I was babysitting my nephew and my niece here, I had to go out to do some things. Then I tried to lay down. If you see here a missing patch of the foundation, that's because I, you know, like sometimes I tend to lay my head on my palm, like so. In general, to be honest, it's not so bad as the first time. It's definitely oily though. After 7-8 hours, since I was checking in the mirror, I couldn't check in with you, but I was checking with the mirror, I noticed that here on my chin, the foundation is was already totally worn off. First here, I don't know if you can see the redness. I will zoom the lens a little bit further so you can see better. Here on the sides, I have patches of the foundation missing. And here in my T-zone, I mean, like, it settled here in my fine lines quite a lot. Now, as I said before, I have deep fine lines, so it's really hard for a foundation to not settle there sooner or later. Let me just zoom in and scare you a bit, because the bit around my nose is the worst one, really. And I hope that when I zoom in, you will be able to see better. Now, this is the worst part, really. Here, the foundation on my upper lip is completely gone, I have to say. But here, let me just turn this way so I can see. I don't know if you can see here around my nose. Here, this area, it looks horrible. It really does. Honestly, if maybe you have normal to dry skin, something like this, you don't have so oily T-zone, it might probably be fine for you. Do I like it for myself? No. Will I be using it again? Probably I will, like if I'm not gonna spend the whole day out, or I mean, I will wear makeup for just a few hours. Is it my favorite? No. What I like is the shade match. I like the fact that it's really lightweight. Again, probably if you have normal skin, you'll be fine with this foundation. It's just that this here, I don't know if you can tell on my forehead here. I don't know if you can see the redness on my chin, which is showing through. So all in all, that's my opinion for the foundation. Again, must be fine for normal skin. I should be okay for dry skin, normal to dry as well. Not my favorite for oily skin though. So guys, that was it from me today. I hope you found a value in this video, and if you did, please give me thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Since it's so small, I need all the support which is possible at this time, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!